Hello everyone, our today's topic is class 9, chapter number 13, why do we fall ill? We have already finished chapter tissue and we have completed its question and answers. Now we have to start our next chapter, that is chapter number 13, biology, why do we fall ill? Human health and diseases in human communities are a very complex issue with many interconnected causes. To dwell upon these issues, let us first understand the basic functions of human body, the basic functioning of human body. We all know that an organism is made up of cells, and cell is the basic unit of life. These cells are made up of various varieties of inorganic and organic chemical substances such as proteins, lipids, carbohydrates, fats, minerals, gases, etc. Each cell, in fact, is a dynamic place as something or other thing is happening in it. For instance, cell regularly receives material from extracellular fluid or outside environment and also discharge or throughout the waste material. So a cell is itself capable of functioning many of the activities inside the body. And cells combine together to form tissues and tissues forms an organ. For example, heart is continuously beating, lungs are breathing to give oxygen to the body cells and simultaneously removing carbon dioxide of the body. Kidney are filtering blood to form urine, brain is thinking. All these activities involve different kinds of organs and are interconnected. For example, if kidney is not working properly and forms urine, poisonous substance gets start accumulating inside our body. Under such circumstances, the brain will not be able to think properly. For all such interconnected activities, body needs energy and also requires regular supply of raw material from outside the body. In other words, we can say regular supply of food is necessary to the body so that necessary components are provided to the cells for proper functioning of tissues and organs. Anything that prevents proper functioning of cells, tissues and organs will lead to lack of proper activities of body. In this context, we shall discuss some following issues such as health and its failure, disease and its causes, types of diseases, means of spreads, principle of treatment, principle of prevention, and some microbial disease. So let us start with health and its failure. The term health was always implies the idea of being well. This word is generally used in context of an individual being healthy or not. However, it is not applied in other contexts too. So we can define, according to the definition of WHO, that is World Health Organization, in year 1948, they have defined health as a state of complete physical, mental and social well-being and not merely absence of disease or infirmity. So WHO in 1948, they have defined the term health. Unne kaha tha ki agar ek person physically, mentally and socially health achha hai, to hi wo person ek healthy person kehlayega. Agar uska mental health achha nahi hai, ya uska physical health achha nahi hai, ya uska सोशल हेल्थ वेलबींग नहीं है, तो वो पर्सन हेल्दी पर्सन नहीं कहलाएगा. फिजिकल हेल्थ, जैसे द फिजिकल हेल्थ प्रॉपर फंक्शनिंग ऑफ ऑल द बॉडी पार्ट्स, दैट इज वेरियस ऑर्गन्स एंड ऑर्गन सिस्टम. मेंटल हेल्थ इम्पायर्स हार्मोनी बिटवीन द इंडिविजुअल एंड इट्स एनवायरमेंट. अ मेंटली साउंड इंडिविजुअल इज फ्री फ्रॉम टेंशन, एंजाइटी एक्सेट्रा. सोशली हेल्दी बोलें तो आसपास की सोसाइटी से उसका बिहेवियर, उसके फ्रेंड्स से उसका बिहेवियर, उसकी फैमिली में उसका बिहेवियर, अगर ये पर्सन के ये सारे ये तीनों एस्पेक्ट्स अच्छे हैं तो ही वो पर्सन क्या कहलाएगा, एक हेल्दी पर्सन कहलाएगा. अगर तीनों में से कोई भी एक एस्पेक्ट अच्छा नहीं है, देन द पर्सन इज नॉट विल बी डिफाइंड एज एन हेल्दी पर्सन. सिर्फ डिजीज फ्री होना ही हेल्दी पर्सन नहीं होता, ये तीनों ही एस्पेक्ट हर पर्सन के लिए जरूरी होता है. सो वी हैव कंप्लीटेड in the introductory portion, and what does health mean? We have seen the definition of WHO. What WHO says about health, it does not only physically, if person is physically fit, then the person is healthy. if all the three aspects is well, is attained by that person in a good manner, then only that person is called as physical, that person is called as a healthy person. Or you three aspects are physical, social and mental. Thank you.